I guess it's a question. Do you want the kind of government that never has opposition? Or when it does, they literally call you names.
Well, maybe this is... Let's be fair about this. Let's be fair about this, Dale and Sandy. Perhaps it could be that most of the people in Josephine County are happy with how Simon Hare and the rest of them, whether you like them or not, are conducting business there.
If that's the case, then Simon Hare and the others would have won the last election when it came to the levy. And the last time that there was an election season before this, one of the sitting county commissioners, he's an incumbent, I got more votes than he did. So, you know, if you want to talk about people stopping you on the street, thank you for what you're doing, I get as much of that as any of the commissioners do, as far as I can tell. That's not science.
Well, then why aren't there more people up there? And so it's not just Dale Matthews and Sandy Casinelli holding them accountable.
Well, you know why. You know very well why. People come up to you, I'm sure, pat you on the back and tell you what a good job that you're doing. And you say, hey, you know, you got a point there. You ought to call in. Oh, no, I'm not going to call in.
And that's true. Come to think of it, yeah, I do. Yeah. we have people like that. Okay.
There are about a dozen of us that come faithfully to all the meetings, and you know, we do voice our opinions. The thing about this is we're a thorn in their side because they violate state law. And they don't like it when we say, hey, look, by the way, you cannot campaign in the ambassador after the ballots have been sent out because it's against the law. And they've been warned about this, and they did it anyways.
All right. Now, to me, what has concerned me is that Oregon has pretty clear open meeting laws.
Very clear.
Okay. You can't have two of the three county – you can't have a quorum discussing – county business. It doesn't mean that you can't.
There's a reason for that, Bill. The reason for it is that we've had for generations in Josephine County and other places too, where commissioners would get together, they'd make these little deals in the back room. It used to be smoke-filled back room, and nobody knew what was going on. It was just done. Oh, our friends got that. Great. We're going to name a bridge after my grandmother. Oh, mm-hmm. That's great. And this is happening here.
I understand. And so to me, one of the most dead bang things the two of you ended up doing was the Rotary Club meeting in Grants Pass, in which, you know, you're at the pizza place. It was a Wild River, right?
Right. Mm-hmm.
And you were asked to leave, but yet you had all three county commissioners who were members of the club talking about county business there, which technically turned it into a public meeting.
Well, right? Two were there at the time, but
two.
Is a public meeting. We were invited to come to this.
That's right. It was on the agenda.
Every year.
It was actually on the agenda calendar, wasn't it?
The county's agenda, right? And mm-hmm. they announced it at the weekly business session. And I've taped this thing for years. And the topic was the state of the county report.
Well, that sounds like county business.
All right. Sure does.
Now, so here's the issue. We talked with you about this a couple of times before. So, to me, this is a dead bang violation of the Oregon Open Meetings Law. I'm not a lawyer, but just from, you know, what I do know about the Open Meetings Law, this would qualify. What happened when you brought it up to the state? Because it would seem to me the state would be delighted to run roughshod on some government officials breaking the law.
They were not delighted to enforce the law.
Really?
As county legal counsel, and that's Steve Rich, and Josephine County has told the commissioner several times, don't worry about it. They're not enforcing the law. Well, that's a nice note.
Okay. Well, I guess you have nowhere to go. If the state's not going to enforce it, where do you go next here, Sandy?
Well, that's it. The reason why Josephine County politics is so corrupt is because we cannot get the state to back us up to enforce its own law. And so they know that there's not going to be any repercussions for it. But Dale has come up with a beautiful, marvelous little way to circumvent all that stuff. And it's called the Court of Public Opinion, where he takes these illegalities and he posts them on YouTube. And this has done more to clean up or expose what's happening in Josephine County than the 3 years that I was in office as a commissioner.
What do you want? What do the two of you want to see from your board?
I want them to follow the law just like everybody else has to follow the law. And they're not doing it.
Well, apparently you don't have to follow the law. You said the state won't enforce it.
If that's the kind of government you want, yeah.
Okay. All right.
Yeah. And there's not supposed to be two sets of rules, one for the good old boys in Josephine County and one for the rest of us.
Well, if I'm going to see all of what goes on with Josephine County government, do I have to join the Rotary?
Well, it would be nice. You know, you might want to consider it.
Okay. And by the way, I have no axe to grind on the Rotary. It just struck me as unusual that how that was working out.
There's nothing wrong with Rotary all over the world. It's just that this is the one place chosen by Josephine County movers and shakers to get together in a private little meeting and talk about what the county's policy is going to be without having to worry about the public.
Oh, those pesky citizens. Yeah,
that's right.
Yeah, the citizens who are not there. Okay.
And when we complain to Rotary International about being kicked out of their Rotary meeting, we got a prompt letter back saying, we are a private organization. We don't have to tell you who our members are. And we don't have to, you know, it trumps state law.
It doesn't trump the state opens meetings law if you have a couple of members who are discussing county business. And it was even on their own calendar.
Well, you know what? You might want to reiterate that to Rotary International because that's not their position that they're taking.
Okay. I sent one back and I'm saying, look, you really don't get involved with your clubs that are part of Rotary. Well, let's suppose that there's a club somewhere that says, anybody that's in a wheelchair, we don't want them in our meeting. What would you say?
Chances are they would say something and yank their chain very quickly.
You would think so.
Yeah. Because they would say that the law is that these people have access.
Well, the law is that we are supposed to have access. We didn't work our way in. I was the first one there. I asked permission to set up from the restaurant staff. Mm-hmm. Yeah, no problem. I'm always there.
All right. Well, Dale, Sandy, I appreciate you continuing to pick the scab. I just don't know where you're going to go on this.
I don't like that analogy.
Well,
then it never heals. The idea is to heal the process by encouraging our county commissioners.
Okay, how about shining the light on the wound? How about shining the light on the wound then? How about that?
Shining a bright light is really good because we watch the cockroaches run.
Okay.